Alright guys, welcome back to Let's Play Rune Factory, a fantasy Harvest Moon. So, in the last episode, we got quite a bit done, actually. Camus is evil, and should burn, and also, I got some Mesu Trout. And it's actually been a little bit since I last recorded, since the last, like, two or three episodes were all one big thing. I think it was three episodes. So it's been like a week or week and a half, right in there. I have some notes on what I need to do today, so I'm gonna get to it. So if we come over here to the frying pan, we make up some popcorn. So that leaves us really close. We need more cooking level. I think I need to be level 72 to do some of the things I need to do. So I'm just trying to do a little bit of this to use up some of my energy. I need more cooking level, I need more decoration levels, so hopefully I can get both of those. And up here at the blender, we're gonna use tomatoes. So after all that cooking, we're over halfway through level 70. Please. And if we drop here by the library and talk to Russell, I'd like a book. I have just the book for you. Accessories, 1 out of 4. This book is a must-have if you want to craft accessories. It costs 6,000. Accessories, 2 out of 4. This is a more advanced accessory book. Costs 9,000. The third volume of the accessory series has come out. I think you'll like it. It costs 18,000. The final issue in the accessories is out. That series went quickly. It cost 29,000. And that puts us down to 32,783. We'll be getting a huge amount tonight whenever we get our shipping done. But I'm not quite satisfied with that. I need to do a lot of crafting if I want to be able to make the rest of the accessories I have the stuff for. So I'm gonna need a lot of gold. Which means we're heading up to Mount Gigant. Oh, I never shipped. Oops. I also never shipped the diamond yesterday. Oops. Make silver rings. That puts us up to decoration level 50. Along with gold rings. And amethyst rings out of those. And that puts us up to decoration level 53. Now I'm gonna check my little notes to see what we can make. Buy one charm. Milk. Wool. Egg. Time to ship. Take our medium fur and turn it into a medium yarn. Take that medium yarn and turn it into a hand-knit scarf. Take my two little crystals and combine it with my charm to make the talisman. A wool handknit scarf. Handmade clothes wore not just the body, but the heart. Talisman. A type of charm that protects its wearer. Small yarn. A small barb. Small ball made of yarn. Can be made in the yarn maker. So we're just doing these three. The handknit scarf actually protects against seal. And it only does 22%, but it gives you 5 defense. And the talisman gives 6 defense, but that's apparently it. Huh. That would do more. I think it's also using another recipe, and that might be why. It should be noted that I'm actually sick right now. My throat's fairly raw, but I'm still recording this because I'm hyped to get through this and get going. I'm almost to the point where I can actually just kind of play off camera for a bit. There's not a lot left to do, and that's why today I'm attempting, cross my fingers, to get through most of that stuff. I'm just going to be getting as much gold here as possible, because I need it both for grinding and for the sake of actually making like 5 more recipes that I can do right now. I'm just getting a huge amount of amethyst instead, though. 1 gold and 1 amethyst. Make the amethyst brooch. Nice. That's actually a level 60, so I'm really glad I got that. So 1 gold and 1 sapphire. Make the sapphire brooch. Need to use the gold to make a gold ring. Then a sapphire and a gold ring together, make the sapphire ring. That's a level 60 recipe. Our decorations are level 55 at this point. That's really nice. So if you take 1 gold, 1 purple grass, and 1 amethyst, 1 gold, 1 purple grass, 1 amethyst, make the gold hairpin. That is a level 62 recipe. So we're starting to stack all these up. The sapphire brooch. This pink sapphire brooch shouts out love, popular among young ladies. The gold hairpin. A traditional hairpin, made with gold and purified with spring water. Poison guard 28%. Sapphire ring. A sparkling sapphire ring. The epitome of all that is cute. An amethyst brooch. This mysterious brooch seems somehow soothing. Seal guard plus 20%. So, yeah. You know, they're nothing too amazing, but they're all options. And if you want to style over the opponent's balls, just, you know, wear something amazing. Medium cheese, a processed dairy product. Many cheeses go well with wine. And the level 22 diamond I mentioned before. I never sold it, so I'll just do that now. Also, I might as well sell these as well. Alright, we're all good. A level 15 diamond. Oof. Hey! I need a bath, please. Amethyst brooch. Currently, decoration level 62. That's a level 29 diamond and a level 22. Jesus. If we come in here into Tauros, we're actually gonna fight the slime. We actually need to kill this guy, both for the little crystals he dropped, and I actually need a water crystal. I don't have one, apparently. I thought I saved my other one, but maybe I used it for something? I don't fully remember, to be honest. A little crystal, which we need, so I'm not gonna, you know, turn my nose up to, but hopefully we get a water crystal tonight. I got it. We take a silver, a water crystal, wind crystal, earth crystal, and fire crystal together. And you get the rosary, a level 70 material, or decoration. We actually were down at 62, so we only had like a 20% chance of doing that. I'm actually surprised we did that. It's very nice though. The rosary, level 1, critical, plus 5%, power guard, plus 15%. Rosary means rose and is used when praying. Also ship all these while I'm here. I apparently have already made 42,000 off of them. They're worth 3,500 apiece. That's not bad, actually. That's a level 5. Okay, yeah, that's not bad. It's definitely worth doing if they're level 1 materials. Even level 2 materials. While I'm thinking about it, all those diamonds. Both of those diamonds, I should say, but really I might as well have just shipped 51 diamonds, because I'm pretty sure I'm going to get close to 51,000 from that. So today we're going to need both money and materials for grinding, so back up to Mount Gigant we go. Hopefully we can get more of those diamonds so that I can sell one or two of them today. That way we can, you know, have enough for everything. Forever. Otherwise I'll have to do the book purchasing right around 5 o'clock. Skill up, nice. Pineapple's done. Nice. So it's a very low chance, but it is a chance. Now, I believe it's a 10% chance right now to make a diamond ring. Six. It only took us 6 tries, but the diamond ring, combination success, decoration level increased. So yeah, that puts us up to level 65 decoration. I need to check something. Take a diamond and a ring to make a diamond ring once again. And another diamond and another ring. Fail. But this time they succeed to make another diamond ring. That puts us at 66 decoration. Oof. Wow, once I'm up to 70, I'm max level with that. Well, not max level, but as max level as I need to be. Okay, the diamond ring. Many maidens' hearts have been captured by a diamond's brilliance. Very simple item, you know. They're just one of these kind of decorative ones. They don't really play a big role in this game, but they're nice, they're pretty, and I'm actually curious how much they're worth, so let's check that. The diamond ring is worth 4,500. Not a bad little ring. I probably should have, you know, sold all those to a shopkeeper, but I'm sure it's fine. I only need to get one level higher, and then I can make the last item I want to make today. So, let's get a tiny bit of more materials, and then I'm done. Take one diamond, one gold. Okay, we're actually almost out of HP at this point. So I'm gonna go heal myself up. Actually, I'll just grab some out of the field here. The Diamond Brooch, combination success. The Diamond Brooch, a golden brooch glittering with diamond shards. They say diamonds last a long time. Poison Guard 16, Seal Guard 16, Paralyze Guard 16. Defense 1. This thing's a nifty little thing. If you combine this with any of the rings, you can pretty much get almost guaranteed plus a little bit of resistance against the others. Or you combine this with... There's one item that gives good resistance against all of them. I don't quite remember what it is, though. So, you know, check it out, see what you want to do. I think it's... Oh, the Happy Ring. That's what it is. It'll get you up to, I think, 100% if you combine this with the Happy Ring. I don't know where that came from, but it just, you know, popped back in my head. So we're gonna pick the pineapples here. Or at least a single stack of them. Or, you know what, let's do both. I can use these to grind up anyway, so... So, pineapple juice. You know... It's made in a blender. I didn't really say it, I just realized that, but whatever. Pineapple juice. Fresh juice from pineapples, sweet and refreshing, has a beautiful yellow color. They're worth 370 apiece, so, you know, not bad. And pineapple. This popular southern fruit tastes sweet and has a summer-like fragrance. These are actually worth more than the juice, so you have to question everything at that point. I don't know who might like pineapple juice, maybe the priest, but I'm not positive. I do know that we have those shipped now, so that's good. So this is an odd errand to be on. But if this is spawning what I think it is, yes, we need an apple. And we can't buy apples yet. So I need to kick the crap out of these until one of them gives me an apple. What a silly quest to be on. The quest for apples. This is why for most fruit, I normally either grow it or buy it. I don't do this, but, you know, this is the only way to do it. Oh, that's the apple. Found apple. And honestly, I just want it off the shipping list too, so I may as well go for a second one. In the future, I'm sure I'll need more, but... there we go. A second apple. Done. If we come over here into the handheld section and make bread, then we can put an orange, a pineapple, an apple, and bread together to make the fruit sandwich. A new little item. That's only a level 4 recipe, so you know, you really can't fail. You can, but that's only if you're level 1, and it's still a 70% chance. Alright, fruit sandwich. Fruit enclosed in bread. Its fruity flavor makes it ideal as a snack. And an apple, sweet and rich in nutrition. These are reported by some to be the key to good health. And both are shipped. We now have 304,941 gold. We're good. We're good on money. Oh. They close at 5 p.m., apparently. He's at the bathhouse, isn't he? I didn't realize he went to the bathhouse, so I can't buy the book I want. I wish I'd realized that, so I'll have to remember that Wednesday I've not gotten any books. So, I want some gunpowder, which means we're not going after the goblin archer, we're going after the standard old goblin. He has two drops I want, the gunpowder and the warrior's certificate? Warrior something. Proof of warrior? I don't remember. I'm forgetting the name for some reason, but it's a good gift. Also, I may need one, but I don't think so. I think I've gotten the one I need for shipping, and I don't know that they're needed for any accessories. There we go. The warrior certificate, yep. Another warrior certificate, so, you know, more gifts for the evil Camus. There we go. Gunpowder. And we're done. Gunpowder. Explosive exposed to fire. Handle with care. It's not worth a huge amount, but more importantly, it fills out the shipping list a bit. Boop! And last, and honestly a little bit least, we're going to be going after the insect jaw once again. One for shipping. Also a skill. Nice. Cross my fingers that I get one tonight. If I do not, then, well, fooey. Insect skin. Yeah, sounds about right. There we go. Insect jaw. Fantastic. So I believe we need one more for something later on, but... not my problem right now. insect jaw, strong enough to bite through anything. There we go. Guys, next time on Let's Play Rune Factory, a fantasy harvest moon. This may have been a short episode for you guys. This could have literally been 10 minutes for you guys, or maybe it's half an hour. Who knows? It's been almost 2 hours for me. I've gotten a huge amount done. I think next episode is going to be the final episode. I'm going to try to make it the final episode before, you know, I just do a bit of a time skip. I just skip to all the holidays, so there will be two more episodes before War and Winter. One where I'm just covering everything, and then one where I just take footage over the next, like, week of me playing the game. And it'll be like a full season, just kind of compacted into one thing. Alright guys, I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.